Hi, hello. Welcome back to this video lecture presentation on mechanics of materials. So in my previous presentation, I have explained that drawing shear force and bending moment diagrams for a cantilever beam with the different types of loads. So in today's presentation, I'll be discussing how to draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams for a simply supported beam with the different types of loads. To start with, let us consider a simple problem in which I have to draw shear force and bending moment diagram for a simply supported beam with the 3-point loads as shown in figure. So now, to start with, first of all, we have to find out support reactions RA and RB. So to find out our support reactions, we know that some of the clockwise moments must be equal to some of the counterclockwise moments. Either we can take moments about point B or support B or support A. So here I have taken moments about A. So what are all the clockwise and counterclockwise moments I have here? And I have considered clockwise moment as positive. So if clockwise moment is positive, counterclockwise moment must be taken as negative. So now if I consider this point A about this point, this 5 into 2 is clockwise. 5 into 2 is clockwise. So that I have taken positive 5 into 2 plus 10 into 4. That is also positive because of clockwise moment. Plus 8 into that 7. 8 into 7, that is also positive. But I am left with this counterclockwise moment due to support reaction at B. Therefore, that is RB into this distance. So that distance is nothing but 8. Since it is counterclockwise moment of point A, that is minus RB into 8. So sum of all that must be equal to 0. So now if I equate that to 0, I'll get support reaction RB as 13.25 Newton. Now we know that for equilibrium, static equilibrium, sum of the upward forces must be equal to sum of the downward forces. So considering that support reaction RA plus RB is equal to 5 plus 10 plus 8. So that is RA plus RB is equal to 23. So I know the value of RB. By substituting here, I'll get RA as 9.75 Newton. So now let us draw shear force diagram. The thing is at different points, what are all the forces that are acting? We have found out what is the force at A. If you want, we can write shear force at A is equal to 9.75 Newton. Shear force at C, okay, that is 5 Newton. Shear force at D is 10 Newton. Shear force at E is 8 Newton. And shear force, that is reaction at B is, that is 13.25 Newton. So if you want, we can write, or even we can write the cumulative shear force at different points. Or even without that, with the sign convention we have, we can directly draw the shear force diagram. Now, after all the loads, just close to this point B, I'll consider a section. So all that left upward is positive as sign convention. If left upward is positive, then left downward is negative. Then right up is negative, right downward is positive. So with that background, I have to draw shear forces at different points. To start with, support reaction RA, it is left upward. Left upward is positive. So with reference to this reference line, I have to draw that RA is 9.75. Above that, I have drawn 9.75. Now if you observe here, from point A to C, there is no other load acting. Therefore, from A to C, it is same load, that is 9.75 Newton. So now at point C, we have left downward. Left downward is negative. So therefore, it will come down by 5. So out of that 9.75, if that 5 comes down, here it will be 4.75 Newton. And up to point D, from C to D, there is no other load. Therefore, from C to D, it is nothing but 4.75 only. So at point D, again, we have left downward of 10. So that is left downward is negative. So from this point, okay, it will go down by 10. So 4.75 And in addition to that, another 5.25 will go down from this point to this point. It must be 10 kilonewton. So that is left downward is negative. From here to here, it will come down by or go down by 10 newton. Now from here to this point, there is no other load. Therefore, 5.25, it is constant. At again point E, left downward, and we have 8 kilonewton. So from here to here, we have 5.25 constant, and from there left downward is negative. Another 8, it will go down. So 8 plus 5.23 will be 8 plus 5.25 is 13.25. It will come down. So now from here to here, there is no other load, and whatever we have at support reaction B, same thing we should get when we complete this Scherfoss diagram from end A to B. So at support reaction B, we have support reaction RB as 13.25, and what the Scherfoss diagram, what we have drawn is correct. So above this mean line, we have to consider positive. Below that one is negative. One important thing is, in while solving this problem, numericals on shear force and bending moment diagram, we need not draw shear force and bending moment at different places. So first we have to draw load diagram, below that one shear force diagram, below that one is bending moment diagram. Because of that space restriction, I'm showing that shear force diagram here, and after calculating that bending, after showing that bending moment calculation, so then once again I have to draw bending moment diagram, all put together, load diagram, shear force diagram and bending moment diagram at one place I have to draw. So now bending moment calculations, so that's what, once again we need not draw this load diagram. Okay, so what is that bending moment at different points? Bending moment, if I start from this point, so that RA into perpendicular distance is zero. End moment is always zero. Therefore, bending moment at A is zero. Bending moment at B is zero. That is what is written here. Bending moment at A is zero. Bending moment at B is zero. Now, bending moment at C. So while finding out bending moment at C, we have to consider sign convention. That is bending moment sign convention. So that is nothing but, we know that left clockwise is positive. So for this point, so the only moment what we get is because of this support reaction that causes what type of moment? It is clockwise. So with reference to this support reaction, section considered at B, okay, this causes at A, it is RA into 2. So RA is nothing but 9.75 into 2. That we get 19.5 newton meter. But important thing is, since it is left clockwise, it is positive. So then bending moment at D. So bending moment at D, again, this left clockwise causes positive. That is RA into 4. RA into 4, that is 9.75 into 4. So that is positive minus 5 into 2. Since that 5 into 2 is counterclockwise, left counterclockwise is negative. Therefore, minus 5 into 2, that's equal to 29 newton meter. Now at point E, RA into 7 is nothing but, that is clockwise moment, left clockwise is positive, minus 5 into 5, minus 5 into 5, that is left counterclockwise is negative, minus 10 into 3, minus 10 into 3, that is also left counterclockwise is negative. So if you simplify, we get bending moment at E as 13.25 newton meter. If we want, we can find out bending moment at B. So that is left clockwise, RA into this, minus 5 into this, minus 10 into this, minus 8 into 1, we will get 0. Even without calculating that, you can straight away write end moment as 0. Now once we know bending moment at different points, with that sign, at point A it is 0, at point B it is 0, And at point C, we have obtained that as 19.5 Newton meter. At point D, we have obtained that as 29 Newton meter. And at point C, we have obtained that as 13.25. So all are positive. So we have to join these by lines. When these are point loads, we can join by lines. If it is uniformly distributed load, we should have drawn these things by parabolic curve. And even triangular load also, we have to draw joined by curve only, cubic curve. So once we draw that, strictly speaking, in the this thing, whenever we are asked to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram, after writing down what is that shear force at different points and what are the bending moment at different points, calculating all those by considering sign convention for shear force as well as sign convention for bending moment, we have to draw diagram like this. So this already we have drawn, and here also bending moment also we have drawn. So this is the shear force and bending moment diagram for the given numerical. So now let us consider one more numerical. So in which we have to So in this numerical also, we have to draw shear force and bending moment diagram for the double side overhanging beam subjected to loading as shown below. So here we have to locate point of contraflexure, if any. So I've already told you or already have explained what are that point of contraflexure or point of inflexure. Point of contraflexure or point of inflexure is the point where that bending moment is zero in bending moment diagram, or it is also the point where the bending moment changes its sign, or the point where the bending moment is zero, or the point where the bending moment changes its sign is known as point of contraflexure or point of inflexure. So if at all, if any point of contraflexures are there in this, that can be known after calculating bending moment. So for that one, first of all, whenever it is simply supported beam, we have to find out support reactions. As I've already told you, that repetition of this load diagram is not required. Okay, when we have that load diagram in the beginning, so below that itself, after calculating shear force and bending moment at different points, we can straight away draw that shear force and bending moment diagram. Or also, if any point of contraflexure or inflexures are available or existing, that also we have to locate. In addition to these things, the point where the shear force is zero in shear force diagram is the point of where the bending moment will be maximum. So that is also one of the salient point. There we have to find out at what distance from the support that shear force is zero, or the point where that bending moment is maximum, that also we have to calculate. Once we find out that distance, making use of that, we have to find out maximum bending moment at that point. So I'm repeatedly telling, no need to draw this load diagram again and again. Only for our convenience here, I have drawn this again. And for that, any simply supported beam, we have to find out support reactions. So to find out support reactions, that same concept of static equilibrium condition we have to use, that is some of the clockwise moments and counterclockwise moments must be equal to zero. If we take clockwise positive, counterclockwise we have to take negative. So the other way, vice versa, is also true. If we take counterclockwise positive, clockwise will be negative. So here we have to find out support reactions R A and R B. To find out that, here I have considered, okay, here directly I have written that support reactions RA is equal to RB is equal to half of that total load acting downwards. That is because it is equal overhang. Here we can observe this is 2 meter. Here also it is 2 meter, and load is over there, is at the center, and even UDL also equally distributed over the beam, and even point loads on either side are equal. Therefore, total 5 plus 10, 15 plus 5, 20, and this is 2 into 6. So 2 into 6, 12. 12 plus 20. So 12 plus 20 is 32. 32 by 2, that is 16 kilonewton. If we come across this type of numericals, we can directly write. Or else if you want to calculate, we have to take either moments about B or moments about A. So I'll simply explain here, taking moments about B. So what are all that moment? So here, this is 5. 5 into this distance, 5 into 8. So if I consider this, this is nothing but counterclockwise. If I take counterclockwise positive, 5 into 8 minus, this becomes clockwise, minus RA into 6, then plus 10 into 3. Again, this UDL also acts as a clockwise moment, a counterclockwise moment. Therefore, plus 2 into 6, whenever it is uniformly distributed load, this is 2 kilonewton per meter. It has spread over 6 meters. Therefore, 2 into 6, and that will be acting at the center as point load. Therefore, 2 into 6 into 3 because of that UDL. Then this also we have to consider, this is acting as clockwise. Therefore, clockwise I have taken negative minus 5 into 2. So with all that relation, we can also find out RA. Once we get RA, RA plus RB is equal to total downward force. Total downward is 5 plus 5, 10, plus 10, 20, plus 6, 20 plus 6 into 2, 12. So that is 32. So total downward force is 32. So with that, RA plus RB, a known value of RA, we can also find out RB. But since we can make out this is equally distributed, we have taken RA is equal to RB is equal to half of that total downward load acting. So once again, I am telling you, so at each and every point, what is that shear force? If you want, we can mark that one, or and no need of drawing that load diagram separately. So below that load diagram itself, after calculating shear force and bending moment, together we can draw this shear force diagram and bending moment diagrams below that load diagram. So now here shear force at C is how much, shear force at A is how much, so that we can write separately or else directly. So without writing also, we can draw that shear force diagram. So now we have to consider section, and it is very important to assume the section before the support and after the load. So here after the load means there is no support here. So therefore, this is the support what we have. If you want, we can assume here also. But for uniformity, I'm assuming a section very close to B. Now, this 5 kilonewton at C is left downward. Left downward, left upward positive means left downward is negative. With reference to that mean line considered, this 5 kilonewton has to be drawn below this. And we can make out from C to A, there is no other load acting. Therefore, it is constant up to here. So now at point A, we have support reaction of 16 kilonewton. So that is nothing but upward. Left upward is positive. So 5 from here to here is already there, another 11. So totally 16. Now from point A to directly I can consider B if I want, or else up to D. This is uniformly distributed load, that is left downward is negative. So now when we consider at this point, contribution due to uniformly distributed load is 0. At this point, contribution is 0, and that is 2 into 3, 6. So left downward is negative. From 11, it will come down by 6. So 11 minus 6, that is 5. So again, at point D, we have left downward is negative. From here to here, 5, another 5 downward. Now again from D to B, it is uniformly distributed load. Therefore, from this point, contribution due to uniformly distributed load is 0, and that is nothing but 2 kilonewton per meter. Therefore, for 3 meters, it is 6. So again, left downward is negative. From here, it has to come down by another 6. Since it is uniformly distributed load, it must be a linear. So 5 plus 6, 11. At this point, it should come and join to this. So because it will come down by another 6, since it is slant line or inclined line, so 11 down means that point we have to mark here, 5 plus 6, 11. So now at point B, it is left, that is upward, that is right upward. Left upward is positive, right upward is negative. So, but in addition to that, if we consider this, one more load is there at E, that is right downward. Right downward is positive. Therefore, we can mark that 5 above, and up to here it is constant. And this is 5, another 11, total 16. So, the bending moment diagram, shear force diagram, what we have drawn is correct. Now we have to draw bending moment diagram. So to draw that bending moment diagram, So now to draw that bending moment diagram, as I told you, once again, no need of drawing this load diagram. So bending moment calculations. So here end moments, that is at point C as well as at point E, bending moments are zeros. So MC is equal to MEA is equal to zero end moments. Now bending moment at E. So now I'm considering section close to this, and this causes 5 into 2. 5 into 2 at point A is nothing but left counterclockwise. Left clockwise is positive, left counterclockwise is negative. Therefore, minus 5 into 2, this is very important, that is minus 10 kilonewton meter. Now, if I consider point D, again, left counterclockwise, that is minus 5 into 5, minus 5 into 5, then this causes clockwise, that is plus RA into 3, plus RA. RA is nothing but 16 into 3. And in addition to that, I have UDL over a length of 3 meters. That also causes counterclockwise. Therefore, that is minus, how much is that load? 2 into 3 is the total load. Moment means it will be act, UDL will be acting at the center into that half of that distance, that is 3 by 2, that is 1.5. So I repeat, for uniformly distributed load, it is 2 into 3 into 1.5. Since it is counterclockwise, it is negative. Therefore, we will get it as 14 kilonewton meter positive. So now I have to find out bending moment at B. So either I can consider all that loads acting to the left of that one, or from here I can consider. So this is nothing but right clockwise. So left clockwise is positive, right clockwise is negative. Therefore, 5 into 2, that is minus 10 kilonewton meter. So now once if I those values, I can mark those points, and whenever it is uniformly distributed load, we have to join by curve. After marking all that bending moments at that respective point, and we have to join. If it is point loads, we have to join by line. If it is uniformly distributed load, we have to join by parabolic curve. Now we can observe here, there are 2 points at which that bending moment is changing its sign, or the point where bending moment is zero. So that is nothing but point of contraflexure or point of inflexure. So whether they ask or not, we have to find out that point of contraflexure. So this is the total diagram, shear force and bending moment diagram for the given type of loading. Now I have to locate that point of contraflexure. For that, let me consider that distance as x. Either we can take from this end or this end. And since it is at two points, so here also taken as x and x. Since it is symmetric loading, so one is sufficient. So now take moments about that section. So moment is nothing but from this into this. So that is again bending moment sign convention we have to use. That is left counterclockwise. So that is 5 into x plus 2. Since it is left counterclockwise, minus 5 into x plus 2. In addition to that, what else we have? This RA. So that is nothing but left clockwise. RA into that distance is x plus RA into x. In addition to that, I have UDL over this length. So over a length of x, I have UDL of 2 kilonewton per meter. Therefore, that causes counterclockwise 2 into x by 2. So sum of all that. So since at that point, the point where that point of contraflexure exists, at that point bending moment is 0, must be equated with 0. So now by simplifying this equation, okay, by solving this quadratic equation or simplifying, we'll get x is equal to 1 meter. So that is nothing but point of contraflexure or inflexure.